where he just melts to the hands of the damage.
Oh, yes, Atlas. Oh, yes.
Consistent damage
wins and four match wins, respectively. I'm going to say that Afrika have the easier to execute after his back to run bot lane, because either he's counter ganking or stopping the Croc Campus. TP.
Yeah, teleport to come in immediately. Aiming's going to be following in here as well, as that's going to be the key landing onto Live. He's very dead. The flash still hasn't come back up. And Dragon does land the Sonic Wave.
I believe
in you, Jeff. Headbutt Pov, not going to be able to get it there as we're even on the Infernal Drake's jelly. Looking for this trample stun as the Meganar is in great timing. That was a very weird resonating strike, but one that works out for Peanut. As now Gen.G are on the run, they're trying to get away with this dragon and their lives. Looks like Life is going to be the one to go down, but that's the only...
Not even a sideways trade, it's a trade down.
Yeah.
For the side of Afrika means their playmaking is going to be a little bit less reliable. But good news, Gen.G have also got multiple summoners down. They're doing a good job of controlling this river. Actually, Jelly's on a bit of a walkabout here.
Yeah, the cow getting corralled just a little bit here. He does have the ultimate available. That's a big pulverize by the Kalista so well.
Ooh, Afrika Sun has the default summons here.
All right, that's the flash headbutt pole, but Ruler's able to get out of there. Can he actually get the knockup? The kick's unnecessary there from Dredd as Ruler just gets obliterated. It's a huge investment, but they get their man.
And this has been Afrika. They're using flash on aiming multiple times to get picks. So they want to get kills, and they're thinking about Baron. They're thinking about the secure of their end. They're on it already.
Whoa, that's a big flash. Fantastic portal jump, but it's not going to be enough as they do manage to make their way back in. The Afrika Freaks have started. This is where aiming is going to have his most relevant item spike. I think Bloodthirster does make things a bit better, but Ruler's found him and he's just dead. Six shots.
See, glass half empty Ezreal off. Well, he doesn't have as much CS. At least his build isn't that expensive. Even Triforce. Hope doesn't do too much, and aiming's low already.
Yep, True Shot Barrage is going to come down. Jelly gets a double knockup, but the Fate Scroll is going to have to be invested just to get...
It's a very consequential timing of Warp. See, now the scaling time
spots this one out. It is going to be a 50-50, but remember, the Ren does exist as Kane.
Oh!
He's going to be out of place. Spoiler, but Peanut! In the game. Yeah, I think that's definitely a thing that you got to do. Dredd didn't even manage to figure that one out as another Party Warp comes in.
Who's partying though, Atlas?
Looking for Ruler. Keen's very fast with his phase rush. Is now Life. Gets the spit out over the wall, but he's going to get punished for it. Has a lot of great health, but not a lot of health bars. Now Dredd getting kited by Ruler. Another Mystic Shot is going to land. Dredd, he's going to survive for so long. That's going to be the shield from Ruler. The last tick of the Ignite, but it doesn't matter. There's just so much damage available. And now it's just aiming against the world. The crush comes in. Aiming gets over that wall. That's a really
cute
play. Can they actually get on top? There are so many sticks. The wallop comes forward. The rend is used early, though, and isn't able to pick up Peanut.
In Afrika, obviously Gen.G have Ruler, but there's always considerations to be had. Some of the other teams can push in here. And
Oh, my God. He's almost just dead. True Shot Barrage is going to miss, and Jelly's going to block that Mystic Shot. Ruler still wants it, though. He's so aggressive. The Undertow picks it up in the end, as now Jelly is going to die as an afterthought. No, does have the Fate Scroll to keep him alive. YOLO.
All right, smite, then rend. Smite, then rend. Smite, then rend.
Well, True Shot Barrage is only going to find Sun. Jelly is at full health. They're looking for the turn, but you can see Dredd just takes so much damage here.
Smite and Ren.
Yep, can we get it? We're at 5,000 health currently. That's a great pulverize, as now the Devour has to be used on the Olaf. That means that the Ezreal's not going to be as safe. Two-man Shockwave. He's going to be there on the front line, and immediately Keen is taken out. Jelly's going to follow. It's a kill for the Nara. It's a kill for the Ezreal. Make that a double as the Kalista's going to go down. That Mystic Shot doesn't land, but Gen.G have won the fight, and they're looking to just win the game.
They're going to probably be able to do it, Atlas. Afrika were too greedy. They were trying to leash the Baron
and
also look for the fight. They get the sticks in, but the sticks aren't going to be enough. They try to shake a stick at Gen.G, but Gen.G outlasts them. The interrupt on the back there might help with this finish.
Yep, and we were talking about the Griffin-Hanwha series yesterday, the blowout that was game number one. We said that's not going to affect the mental. This is a game that throws your mental through
I'm
a complete...
Tilted.
Luke. Yeah, I know. And we were watching Challenger earlier today. I thought that was going to be the most tilting game of the day. It's going to be this one as Gen.G steal the victory from the Afrika Freaks and keep KT's hopes alive. Since Zoe made her way into competitive play.
They're looking to be proactive and maybe the Vayne and Neek.
Keen and Dredd. Hanging out here, seeing whether Dredd can actually get an early gank down here. Level 3, but Peanut's going to come up with a level advantage. That is going to be the first snare landing onto Keen, but also him getting stunned. And that's a very quick kill there from Dredd. The flash body slam was a great one, and now Peanut could be in trouble. We're looking for a blade surge, but we're not going to get it. The center of attention.
Thinking of agency. Dread pops the Predator.
Yeah, he's looking for it. That's a good devour, but it's going to be life, taking a fair bit of damage. Jelly's looking for a headbutt pole, but Fly's coming on over. Dread in trouble. 300 health now after he takes a bit of a drink, but Peanut should be able to get in here and get some control over the enemy blue buff side.
Imagine both junglers just a couple of camps away from level 6. Could be a re-engage.
Yeah, this is going to come in here. It's going to be life. Does have the great health available now as Ruler. Free hitting onto Jelly. Going to be able to get the tumble. That's an auto from Fly that secures the first kill.
The Shelly charge.
Oh, wow. Fly actually getting a lot of damage there onto Dread and keeping himself safe from the ultimate. That's a huge deal as Peanut will be able to secure this Ocean Drake. Takes it down without having to use the smite. I feel like if you're in a fight, the only buttons you need to press are E.
Well, right now, some stun buttons are being pressed.
Yeah, that's a decent condemn into the wall there. A Silver Bolt is going to get a lot of damage. Ruler actually getting the dodge, which is beautiful. Vanguard's Edge doesn't find the mark. They don't have vision, so Dread survives for so long, and eventually it's Peanut that grabs that kill. Pop Blossom has to be flashed as now Cuvée gets himself.
Maybe. Yeah. That's Cuvée. We're going to watch the replay. Look, Cuvée's not even low health on this play. Vanguard's Edge doesn't go wide, and, well, nice Pop Blossom. You're dead. ADCS dying to the turrets like it did in game number one. Just on them that you might think.
Well, right now, Predator has been popped here from Dread, gets the Chilling Smite down, Ruler's there for the potential, but Peanut just doesn't press Safeguard. He gets the kickback onto Keen, who goes immediately into his stopwatch, and now, oh my goodness, the snare was just too good. Ruler now with that Ginsu's Rage stacked up, looking for his second. That's going to be the kill onto the cow, and somehow...
You don't even know.
Nope. And it's taking so much damage. There's so much Ginsu's Rage in this Baron Pit. Final Hour is going to get popped as Dread does have the opportunity to try and steal. He goes into his stopwatch, though. It's down to 2,000 health as Ruler is looking for Sun. Just kills him on the backline. No, not quite able to do so. Is aiming one auto attack. Ruler needs to get in there, and he does. Fly looking for it now. The Baron is helping so much, but who's it helping? It's taken by Fly, of all people. This series is absolutely insane, and now the Afrika Freaks are stuck in a pit, but the Aurelia is still alive. Life gets the gray health back. The Vayne is dead, though. It's Cuvée. The last hope here is now Keen is alive. He had the GA. The flash has to be used, and they just want to keep Barons alive now.
For just some chance of an engage from someone like Jelly or Keen. So the fact that they could clean up some Baron buffs means the first Baron was more of a gold Baron for Gen G that gets them ahead for the first time this game. They need a second Baron to grow the lead as Dread doesn't know this is Cuvée.
Yeah,
he knows for sure now.
I don't know whether he actually cares all that much. He gets a free delivery and Pop Blossom ain't gonna say once again, but look at Peanut's positioning. This steal is well and truly on the line. It's
Gen
a 50-50.
Gen G getting all of these, Atlas.
Yeah, Cuvée can't actually manage to get this one here as the fight is going to break out. Life has that one available. The Devourer is in, but Keen has great position into the backline, but Ruler just juking him out, able to then transition as Fly gets a lot of damage into the backline, and the Vayne even picks up a...
Before Ruler even stacked up his Rage Blade, and that Rage... ...a cheetah, but like, in a zoo. It's not actually happening in the wild like it should have been. That's a lot of toke damage.
Yeah, I think the cow's going back to the wild as Silver Bolt. That's true damage, my friend. Your Unbreakable Will's really breakable right now. Double kill, triple kill for Ruler. Trying to chase after Sun, but he's at least able to get away for the moment. But they know exactly what is on the menu here. Gen G just want to win the game. The Abyssal Voyage to bring in Peanut. They're not going to take Ruler on forward as Sun just takes about a billion damage from a tumble empowered auto attack. Flawless duet certainly isn't that as the Vanguard's Edge comes in. Keen has to try and do something and life is just going to eat him. Sun goes down. That's the GA. Now Nexus turret number two is going to go down. The Pop Blossom's there. Keen's just running for the hills. That's going to be the full house. It's going to be Ruler's full of flies and the Nexus goes down 2-0 for Gen G.